is the traditional opportunity in the year where we think about, as we start Lent, our own mortality. Not the easiest service, but an interesting opportunity, and one that I think is important that we experience the highs and the lows of the church calendar year. So welcome if you are here, welcome if you're watching this online, either now or after the service has been recorded. We begin with a formal welcome today. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and also with you. Siblings in Christ, from the earliest days of the church, Christians have observed with great devotion the time of our Lord's passion and resurrection. It became the custom of the church to prepare by a season of penitence and fasting. At first, this season was observed by those who were preparing for baptism at Easter, and by those who, having been excommunicated, were to be restored to the communion of the church. But by keeping it these days with care and attention, Christians take to heart the call to repentance and the assurance of forgiveness proclaimed in the gospel, and grow in faith and devotion to our Lord. So by self-examination and repentance, by prayer and fasting, by self-denial and acts of generosity, and by reading and meditating on the Word of God, let us keep a holy Lent. We begin today's service, as we always do here at All Saints, by lighting the Christ candle. Thank you, Leanne. We light a candle, the Christ candle, to recall that in Jesus, the most radical, inbreaking presence of God lights our way. We open the Bible, a collection of people's encounters with the living God. And we pour out this water as a reminder of our baptism in the Holy Spirit. As we look upon the hills and valleys, we see the love poured out upon this land by those who have cared for this land since time beyond measure. We honour those who have gone before and those who are yet to come. May we be mindful of the calling God places on humanity to care for creation. May we take the lead from the Whadjuk people, whose stories are entwined with the stewarding of this place. May we learn from them and walk with them. Please join me in our call to worship. Let us worship God. Enfold me in your love, dear God, yet pierce my heart with your mercy. In the cascading of your compassion, scour away all that offends. The truths to which I am blind are hidden so deep, so secretly. Bring the light of your wisdom to the depths of my heart. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new steadfast spirit within me. As we enter this solemn service, we ask God that we be a channel of their peace with our first hymn. Let us continue with prayer. Let us pray. O God, you alone are holy and merciful. Help us to rest in your grace and find the treasure of life in the service of Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God now and forever. Amen. Today, our Bible reading comes from the Gospel Lectionary reading assigned for Ash Wednesday. Thank you, Leanne.
Our reading today comes from the Gospel of Matthew. Jesus is teaching his disciples and the crowds, a block of teaching that is often called the Sermon on the Mount. We pick up the teaching as Jesus speaks about the practice of fasting and giving to the poor. A reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 6, verses 1 to 21. Beware of practicing your righteousness before others in order to be seen by them, for then you have no reward from your Father in heaven. So whenever you give alms, do not sound a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, so that they may be praised by others. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be done in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, so that they may be seen by others. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward. But whenever you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. When you are praying, do not heap up empty phrases as the Gentiles do, for they think that they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them, for your Father knows what you need before you ask him. Pray then in this way: Our Father in heaven, may your name be revered as holy. May your kingdom come. May your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. And do not bring us to the time of trial, but rescue us from the evil one. For if you forgive others their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. And whenever you fast, do not look somber like the hypocrites, for they mark their faces to show others that they are fasting. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face, so that your fasting may be seen not by others, but by your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust consume and where thieves break in and steal, but store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. In this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Loving God, may my words be loving and true, and may those who listen discern what is not. Amen. In our modern world, there are many ways that you can give. One I have noticed becoming more popular is the trend of posting on Facebook, requesting people to donate to a cause for your birthday rather than buying presents. This can be a wonderful way to enable a charity to receive financial support from your friends. It can also enable people to think how generous you are for supporting this charity. Do the motivations for giving matter? Ash Wednesday marks the first day of Lent and is an opportunity for all Christians to reflect on their own mortality, and hence why the focus is on the importance of being reconciled with God. This is a tradition that some churches have stopped marking, as it can be uncomfortable and reflect on the tougher aspects of life. But for me, that is precisely the point. Ash Wednesday is an opportunity to sit in the discomfort and reflect on our lives over the past 12 months and more. So let's turn to the words of Jesus used each year for Ash Wednesday. Matthew includes five blocks of Jesus' teaching in his gospel, and today's reading comes from the first. He begins with, "Beware of practicing your righteousness before others in order to be seen by them." Or in other words, be careful of demonstrating your faithfulness before others. An odd reading in some ways for Ash Wednesday, when we mark ourselves with ash for all the world to see. But it is important to understand the motivations behind this warning. First, it's important to say that there is nothing wrong with the practices Jesus is describing. Generosity, prayer, and fasting are strong traditions in our faith and are worthy ways to demonstrate your faith and connect with God. And we do see this in this reading. Jesus says, whenever you give alms, whenever you fast, and when you pray. It's not if you pray, but when you pray. Jesus expects his followers to be generous, to pray, and to fast. But he is concerned with the motivations. If someone is praying just so they can be seen by others, then Jesus labels them a hypocrite. If someone is fasting just so they can be seen by others, then Jesus labels them a hypocrite. If someone is giving just so they can be seen by others as generous, Jesus calls them a hypocrite. Instead, if we are praying, giving, or fasting, it should be for God, not for the attention and congratulation of others. But let's be honest. When was the last time you did something without getting some kind of reward? Even if it's just the feeling of warmth and goodness you get from the act of giving itself, or the love of a family member or friend that's given in return. It is very difficult, if not impossible, to give without some kind of benefit. But there is a difference between those who give generously and with no expectation of acclamation or reward, and those who give for the public attention and perhaps more followers on Instagram or Twitter. Secondly, I do not believe Jesus is suggesting that our church life should be carried out in secret where no one else can see it. On the contrary, being a visible presence in our community can be an important way to spread the good news of Jesus Christ. But that's the difference. If we are practicing our faith to worship and honour God and spread the good news of Jesus, then we are righteous. If we are practicing our faith so people will congratulate us on being so nice, so wonderful, so Christian, then we are the hypocrites. As we go from today and begin the season of Lent, perhaps beginning a new Lenten discipline, let us be reminded that first and foremost, we come together and worship for God. We practice our faith for God. We pray, fast, and give for God. Amen. Blessed are you, God of all creation. You are eternal. We are mortal, formed from the dust of the earth. As we receive these ashes, make them a sign for us of repentance and returning to you. Breathe into us again the breath of life. Blessed be God forever. Come, receive the sign of ashes. The ashes we have today are burned, blessed palm crosses, which were gifted to me from an Anglican church in Subiaco, as we haven't kept ours from last year. If you would like, please come forward and you'll receive the sign of the cross on your forehead, or if you would prefer, you can put out the back of your hand and I will place the cross there instead. If you cannot come forward, at the end, I will come to you. Let us pray. Merciful God, you call us and we close our ears. Your beauty shines forth and we shut our eyes. You stretch out your hands to bless us and we pass you by. You delight in us and we despair of ourselves. We ask your healing, O God. Have mercy on us and forgive us, O Lord. Merciful God, we betray our love and our desire for you. Distort the joy and passion you kindle in our hearts and choose to be less than you who made us. We neglect to give thanks and draw back from prayer. We fail to bear witness to the faith that is in us. We ask your healing, O God. Have mercy on us and forgive us, O Lord. Merciful God, we cherish the things that divide us from others and are reluctant to make peace. We treat those who differ from us with prejudice and contempt. We are quick to judge and eager to assign blame. We waste and pollute your creation and lack concern for those who come after us. We ask your healing, O God. Have mercy on us and forgive us, O Lord. Merciful God, we condemn other people's faults and justify our own. We resent correction and cling to the pride that hardens us against the truth. We gossip heedlessly, we wound and exploit other people. We are envious of the gifts you give to others and dissatisfied with the ones you give to us. We ask your healing, O God. Have mercy on us and forgive us, O Lord. Merciful God, we refuse to share what you have given so generously and take lightly the wrongs and sufferings of others. We keep silent when the truth you ask us to speak is hard. We are unwilling to overcome evil with good and draw back from the cross. We ask your healing, O God. Have mercy on us and forgive us, O Lord. As Jesus forgave the woman taken in adultery and Peter who betrayed him, so too does God bless and forgive you. You are much loved. Your sins are forgiven. Be at peace. Amen. And so, as we are reconciled with God, we have the opportunity to reconcile with each other by sharing the peace. And so I invite you to share the peace with your neighbour. The peace of the Lord be always with you. let us sing of the comfort of God's presence with our next hymn. Luckily, God can take away the sins of my inability to keep timing in the music, apparently. In the deserts of this world, you may find signs of God. In the wilderness of your lives, may you be encouraged by God. In your joy and in your sorrow, may you rejoice in God. Amen. Go forth in peace to live your Lenten discipline. We go fat in faith and hope. Amen. I invite you to turn towards your neighbour and sing our blessing of stillness.